Had a picture in my head of how I thought it ought to go. But look who showed up instead. Turns out you never know. Love will steal you by surprise and take your heart just like a thief. Love can bring a stubborn man down to one knee. And I wouldn't change a thing. It's perfectly imperfect, so crazy, but it's worth it. And I'm wrapped around you like this ring. And something tells me even if I could, I wouldn't change a thing. Love will show you what you lack. Love will laugh at all your.
Before you even knew me, you knew me best.
Before you ever asked me, I said yes.
Come walking down.
I breathe in
and I breathe out.
I'm gonna fall in love for the first time. You're gonna show me just what it feels like. I'm gonna walk like I walk down the aisle my whole life, giving it all that you know.
Stand in the presence of God as the bride and JC. Thank you. as we are going to pray, let's close our eyes. Thank you for, Lord, we thank you for this blessed occasion that you have given us. What a wonderful day that you have given us. You are a God who answers our prayer. Lord, we acknowledge your presence in this place and we thank you for your grace and mercy that is entered that forever. You are God of generation, O God. Lord, we thank you as we are here in your presence. You are already here and we lift your holy name in this place, O God. Father, we pray as Denise and also Sini are going to be wedded today. May the unseen hand of the Lord be in this place, O God. Lord, when we begin anything with you, you are God who will be with us until the end of our life, as you are the Alpha and the Omega. You are the beginning and the end. I pray, my Father, as every program that is going to take place in this place, only your name be glorified, O God, that everything that we do may bring forth thy glory and your name glorified in the midst of us. Thank you for hearing our prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Hallelujah. You may be seated in the presence of God. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. I greet you all in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. What a blessed time, what a blessed time that the Lord has given. I know, Sini, I'm seeing you after a while, but you look so beautiful today. And so, Dennis, we have a reason to rejoice in the presence of God, because it is God who is the author and the finisher of our faith. And he is the one who is in control of every situation. You know, I don't want to extend my words today. I will be very short in saying a few things and I'll get to my responsibility. I know Matthew family, Pastor Matthew, George and family for the last 25 years. In fact, I came in 1990. I was not even a believer at that time. I joined in this church. I remember the first message I heard in this church was from Pastor Matthew George. I believe he was the secretary of that church at that time. You know, so memory goes back in detail, but it's a blessed family. And I really thank God because we are a team of ministers, council of ministers in our church with 3 pastors, 2 deacons and 2 evangelists. And in fact, Sabu George is one of our evangelists. He just moved away for recently for Bible studies. Other than that, he's still part of us. That is Sini's older brother and his wife, Jilu. I'm so happy to see them, and also Sibi and Dawn and children, and Chandamayanti. What a blessed time. And I will leave the other part introducing the Matthew family and talking about them a little bit to the pastors. You know, that'll be more appropriate. But talking about Sini for a few seconds, I know Sini very well. I told you I know her for 25 years. I think she was almost, I don't know exact age, but 6 years, I believe, when I met you. And I taught her Sunday school for several years. I taught her Sunday school. Well, one thing I realized, you know, I'm not telling that I have a great discernment, but with the knowledge I have, given choices, Sini will never make a wrong choice. And I do believe, and I'm sure, Sini made the right choice. Denise, you are getting really a blessed person in your life, and I hope the other way too. And I do believe the blessing of the Lord be upon your life. You know, we have every reason to celebrate today. If I say, if you really can, if I can pop into their heart to see how they are celebrating now, you know, they are truly celebrating in their heart. They rejoice in their heart. Maybe they are just thinking, you know, why they are prolonging this program. Pastor Johnson, why don't you just come and hold our hands and say the vows, let us be done and we want to begin our life together. You know, there is an urgency I can just sense in their heart. So, yeah. And leave us alone. There goes, amen, praise God. But I acknowledge the presence of God. I thank him. So having said that, I myself cannot prolong my words. But I'll get to my responsibility on behalf of both the families. I want to invite the ministers of the gospel to this glorious and blessed time and occasion, the groom and the bride, and both the families and members of both the families. and members of both the churches, all friends and all guests. What is special on this occasion is, I don't know about many weddings in the world, the Lord Jesus Christ is in the midst of us. And His presence we can truly experience at this moment. May God bless each one of us. And as we are celebrating and rejoicing, let us acknowledge that He is here. So whatever we do may bring glory to His holy name. And at this time, I request the English worship team, IPC Hebron, to lead us in worship at this time.
Praise God. Let us stand in the presence of God this morning. God has been so good. Hallelujah. He's a gracious, He's a marvelous, He's an ever-loving, ever-present God. Let us gaze our eyes upon Christ this morning as we are celebrating the lives of Dennis and Sini. And sing along with us as we worship God. In the back of your program sheet is the lyrics to the song, and let us look to Christ this morning as we sing to Him.
In Christ alone my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are still, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe, this gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones He came to save. Till on that cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on Him was laid. Here in the death of Christ I live. There in the ground His body lay. Light of the world by darkness laid. Then bursting forth in glorious day, up from the grave He rose again. And as He stands in victory, sin's curse has lost His grip on me. For I am His and He is mine, bought with the precious blood of Christ. No guilt in life, no fear in death, This is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. No power in hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hands till he returns or calls me home. Here in the power of Christ I stand. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. Till on that cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid. Here in the death of Christ I live. And as he stands in victory, sin's curse has lost its grip on me. I am his and he is mine, bought with the precious blood of Christ. No power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hands till he returns or calls me home. Here in the power of Christ I stand. No power, no power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hands till he returns or calls me home. Here in the power of Christ I stand.
God, you may be seated in the presence of God, in Christ alone. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Jesus. We are so blessed to have Pastor Sujit Jacob with us this morning. We'll be sharing from the Word of God. It is the Word of God that keeps us, sustains us. I do believe that is the manual the Lord has given us for every situation of our life, and more so for a better life. So, at this time, I request Pastor Sujit Jacob to come forward to share from the Word of God.
Man, what a beautiful reminder of God's faithfulness this morning. I'm just richly blessed to be a part of this occasion. You guys look great. My name is Sujit Jacob, and I am a part of the team of pastors in the church that Dennis worships back in Oklahoma City. Such an honor to be here. I have known Dennis as a good friend and a faithful brother for several years now. We are a part of the same missional community and discipleship group. And when I think about Dennis, Dennis loves Jesus. Dennis loves people. Dennis loves to serve. Dennis is like everywhere at the same time on a Sunday morning. And Dennis, obviously today I realize also that Dennis is gifted by the Lord to find an amazing woman and somehow convince her to marry him. So that is about Dennis. Sini, me and my wife have known Sini for almost a year now, and what a incredibly gracious woman of God. It has been just a privilege to know her and walk with this beautiful couple for the past several months in their premarital counseling. So marriage is such a celebratory event. I love the time when family and friends and well-wishers and men of God come together to bless the couple. There is so much collective wisdom in this room. And you see that there is a lot of counsel and there's a lot of advice that is given to the couple on the occasion of marriage. The Bible has quite a bit to talk about, to say about on the topic of marriage. So this morning I want to turn our attention to the book of Ephesians chapter 5. And the Apostle Paul, by the inspiration of the Spirit, calls our attention to verse 20 and 21 specifically this morning, where the mandate of a godly husband and the mandate of a godly wife is to give thanks always and for everything to God the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, submitting to one another out of reverence for Christ. Now, I know that this is church. I know that this is a Saturday morning. But let's be honest. It is beautiful. It is meaningful. But it is one of the most incredibly difficult thing to do. If you've been married for more than 5 minutes, you would agree with me, right? So to submit to one another out of the reverence for Christ. So this morning, it would be a disservice to walk away, give a beautiful advice like this, and walk away without unpacking what it means to submit to each other out of reverence for Christ. So for that, we must start where every good story starts, which is in the beginning with God. Let's pray. Holy Spirit, we honor you. We pray, God, that you would fix our eyes on Jesus, fill our hearts with worship, allow us to listen with open ears to your word, to your voice. In Christ's name we pray. So when the Bible gives an account of creation, the Bible starts by saying that out of God's infinite wisdom, God created man, the first man, Adam, in his image and in his likeness. And God created Adam, and God saw that it was not good for Adam to be by himself. So God created a suitable helpmate for Adam. So God created Eve in his image and likeness. And then God brought Eve to Adam, and the first marriage was instituted in the Garden of Eden. And so Adam saw Eve, and the brother broke into poetry. He started singing. He said, this at last is the flesh of my flesh and bone of my bones. You know, she shall be called woman. You know, so God created Adam and Eve and clothed them with equal worth and value and dignity and gave them separate specific roles that complement each other, roles that help each other to thrive in their affections for God and each other. And so we know the story that Adam's role was specifically to sacrificially love and to protect and to contend for Eve. To create an environment where Eve would flourish to the maximum potential that God has called her to. And Eve's role was to respond to Adam with honor and love and submit to his leadership and create a conducive environment where Adam could grow into his maximum potential. And then we see that these roles were followed from a place of security and identity and a rest in who God was. Now, the perfect unity that was within Adam and Eve, that was in their relationship, did not last long. By the time we come to chapter 3, we see that in a willful act of rebellion against God, Adam passively, sinfully abdicates his role, his responsibility to protect Eve. And he's passive, and you see that instead of being a suitable helpmate, Eve uses her influence and gifting to be a stumbling block to Adam. And sin enters into God's perfect world. And the effects of sin fractures God's world. And you see here that God, both of them sinned. Adam sinned and Eve sinned. And both of them have equal responsibility. But God calls Adam to account because Adam has a unique responsibility as a spiritual head of the home to account before God. And God calls Adam, and Adam, how does he respond? He responds with the first blame shifting in all of history. He says, this woman that you created, she's the one who made me stumble. And then Eve feels the brokenness, the heaviness, the weight of sin in her desires towards her husband. We see that from that time onwards, the ground started producing thorns and thistles, which means that from that time onwards, because of the effect of sin, nothing that was worth enjoying, nothing that was worth pursuing, nothing that had eternal value came free, came without labor. That included marriage too. where Adam and Eve had to work to contend for each other. And if I stop the sermon here, this will be the most depressing sermon that has ever been preached. And if God stopped the story here, there would be no hope for humanity, right? But God, in his rich kindness, rich mercy towards us, he sent Adam and Eve out of the Garden of Eden with a promise that he would send a rescuer to rescue Adam and Eve and the sons of Adam and Eve one day from the effects of sin. And in the fullness of time, God kept his promise. God sent his very own son, Jesus Christ, who entered space and entered time and was born of a virgin and lived a perfect life, a sinless life of obedience. And Jesus, who's often called as a second Adam, Jesus started to clean up the mess that Adam had created. Every time that Adam was passive in pursuing his wife, Jesus was active in sacrificially pursuing his bride, the church. Every time Adam sinfully shifted the blame upon his wife, Jesus took the blame upon himself. Every time Adam selfishly looked away, Jesus kindly, in his kindness, in his mercy, pursued his bride. Now, you must be wondering, where am I going with this? Why am I saying this? This is not a revival meeting. Why am I saying this on the occasion of marriage? Because it has everything to do with marriage. Today, I want to remind us that the strength of Christian marriage does not come with improved techniques. The strength of a Christian marriage does not come with improved communication, although it is important. The strength of Christian marriage comes from the fact that a man who is forgiven and a woman who is forgiven, a man who stands in the righteousness of Jesus and a woman who stands in the righteousness of Jesus come together, and out of the freedom, out of the knowledge that they stand in the strength of Christ, they love each other, they pursue each other. We don't forgive and we don't love when it's convenient. You know, Jesus Christ, his able shoulders carry the weight of marriage, because of which today we can stand in the light of that strength and pursue and love each other. You know what this means? That no longer do we contend to be right. No longer do we have to contend to get our last word in. No longer do we have to defend ourselves. And you know why? Because Christ has declared us righteous. Christ has defended us and declared us forgiven. Christ has declared us free to sacrificially love. And the perfect love that Jesus has for a husband and Jesus has for a wife casts away the anxiety, casts away the fear, and casts away the sin that often holds us back, restrains us from showing affection, showing love. Now, for Dennis and Sini, what this means, you know, for you guys would be that, remember this, that all the days of your life, between you both stands Jesus Christ. Between both of you stands Christ with his righteousness, with the fullness of his forgiveness, with the fullness of his love. Which means that every time you engage each other, every time you face disappointments, every time that you face excitement, every time that you face boredom, every time that you face passion, in all situations of life, Christ stands between both of you. So which means that you don't get to go over him. You don't get to go around him. You don't get to go under him. You get to go through him. You get to go through him as you talk, as you pursue, as Dennis pursues Sini, like Christ pursued the church and gave himself up for her. You don't do that in your strength. You do that in the perfect strength of Jesus Christ, who declares you righteous, who declares you forgiven, who has purchased a right standing for you before the Father. When Sini submits to the spiritual leadership of Dennis, you do so because you are reminded that Christ submitted perfectly to the Father. Now you stand in the shadow of that submission. So this is a reminder. This is a reminder for every groom, every bride sitting in here, that God has called us to love each other and submit to each other out of reverence for Jesus Christ. And as you do it, you are calling out to each other. You are calling out to each other. You're reminding each other the story of the gospel. You are reminding each other that the way I love you sacrificially, the way I love you selflessly, is the way my King loves me. The way I respond to your leadership is the way my King has freed me to do so. And as you start to do that, something beautiful happens. Your story starts to be written into the grander story of the gospel. And your story starts to take its place in the grander story of the gospel. This is what a watching world sees when Jesus Christ is put to display in the life of a godly couple. So if you're here and you are listening to what I'm saying this morning, I want to remind you that if you have not experienced the love of Christ, love of God in Christ, take a moment and ask God to fill your heart. Because scripture says that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son that whoever believes in him may have eternal life. And if you're here and if your marriage looks like an uphill battle, I want to encourage you, would you ask God to give you eyes and give you power to see how much Jesus loves you through the gospel so that your marriage may reflect the grander story, the beautiful story of the gospel. So our prayer as your friends and as your family and as your well-wishers is this, that God, the Holy Spirit, would grant you eyes to see and power to write the most incredible story, love story that has ever been written. Not just an emotive story that is just one chapter deep, but a story that reflects King Jesus, a story that displays his power, a story that reminds you and a watching world that you are called to submit to each other out of reverence for Christ. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for your kindness. We thank you for your grace. Holy Spirit, we just pray, God, we just ask that you will bless Dennis and Sini and keep them and make your face shine upon them. And Holy Spirit, we pray that you will empower them with your presence and your nearness, Lord God, that they may walk in your power, in your love. God, we pray that every engagement, every interaction, every dream, Lord God, every ambition would be colored by your love. God, would be rooted and grounded in your presence, Lord. We pray that you'll keep them, Lord God. And we just ask, Holy Spirit, that all the days of their lives, they will walk out your plan. They will walk out your purpose, Lord God. Father, to this end, we give you all the glory, honor, and praise. Thank you. Thank you for bringing them together. Thank you for keeping them. Thank you, God, for the purpose and plans that you have laid for them even before the foundations of the earth were laid. We love you. We bless you. We bless them in the name of the Father, Son, and the Spirit. In Christ's name we pray. God bless you guys. We love you guys.
Thank you, Pastor Sujit, for that wonderful and encouraging message. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. See, God is not just involved on the day of wedding. He's involved in the every day of our wedded life. That makes all the difference. In fact, humanity started with a wedding, and Christ's public ministry origin with a wedding. And finally, the church, when joined with Christ, a celebration of wedding is there. So God is involved in wedding. At this time, I request the Ebenezer Full Gospel Assembly worship team to come forward. They'll be singing, leading us worship in Malayalam. Ebenezer Full Gospel Assembly.
Para ഉള്ളം നന്ദി നിറയും നീ സന്ന അമ്മോട് സ്തുതി പാടിടുമേ ദേവാ സന്ന അമ്മോട് സ്തുതി പാടിടുമേ മണ്ണിടത്തിലടിയ ജീവിക്കും നാളെന്നും വന്ന് നം ചെയ്യും തിരുനാമത്തിനു ദേവ വന്ന് നം ചെയ്യും തിരുനാമത്തിനു അന്ത്യം വരെയും എന്നെ കാവൽ ചെയ്തിടുവ അന്തികയുള്ള മഹൽ ശക്തി നീയേ നാദ അന്തി യുള്ള മഹശക്തി നീയേ എന്നോടുള്ള നിൻ സർവ നന്മകൾക്കായി ഞാൻ എന്തു ചെയ്യേണ്ടു നിനക്കേശു പറ ഇപ്പോൾ എന്തു ചെയ്യേണ്ടു നിനക്കേശു പറ നന്ദി കൊണ്ടെൻ്റെയുള്ള നന്ദി നിറയും നീ സന്ന അമ്മോട് സ്തുതി പാടിടുമേ ദേവാ സന്ന അമ്മോട് സ്തുതി പാടിടുമേ അന്ത്യം വരെയും എന്നെ കാവൽ ചെയ്തിടുവാൻ അന്തികയുള്ള മഹൽ ശക്തി നീയേ നാഥ അന്തികയുള്ള മഹൽ ശക്തി നീയേ മണ്ണിടത്തിലടിയ ജീവിക്കും നാളെന്നും വന്ന് നം ചെയ്യും തിരുനാമത്തിനു ദേവ വന്ന് ചെയ്യും തിരുനാമത്തിനു എന്നോടുള്ള നിൻ സർവ നന്മകൾക്കായി ഞാൻ എന്തു ചെയ്യേണ്ടു നിനക്കേശു പറ
Praise God. Now we are coming to that moment. We have been truly waiting, and more so Dennis and Sini. You know, Pastor John Johnson will be officiating this wedding, and he's pastor of Ebenezer Full Gospel Assembly. Without adding anything more, I just welcome and request Pastor John Johnson to come forward.
Praise the Lord. As Pastor Joseph Samuel in his introduction said, in Psalm 118 verse 24, it says, "This is a day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it." I know today is a joyous day for Dennis, for Sini, for Dennis's father, mother, and all his relatives, for Babungo Shandamiyandi and Sini's siblings and families, and for both churches. We rejoice with you, and we are glad for you this morning. We know the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ is here with us. Honorable pastors, family and friends of Dennis and Sini, I greet you all in the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. As Pastor Joseph Samuel has said, I have known Sini from the time she was born. Babungo and Chandamiyandi, they've been part of our church ever since they came to this land in the early 80s when my father, the late Reverend K.V. Johnson, was pastoring the church. Because of the lack of time, I don't want to say much, but Babungo Chandamiyandi, God has given them three children, Sabu, who's married to Jilu, Sini, Don, the children CJ and Dominic, and Sini. And Sini is the youngest and the last child. As Pastor Rajungal said, I had the privilege of teaching her Sunday school also. As she was in her high school years, I would ask the children in the class, "What would you like to be when you grow up?" And she always, as Pastor Rajungal said, always wanted to be an attorney. And so today she is an attorney, and she has turned out to be a wonderful, wonderful daughter. Sini, I want to say, any father would be proud to have a daughter like you. I'm so proud of you. We are gathered here in the sight of God and in the presence of this company of witnesses to unite this man and woman in holy matrimony. As we have heard in the eloquent message by Pastor Sujit, marriage is an honorable estate instituted of God. God said, it is not good for man to be alone. I will make him a suitable helper. God united Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden and blessed them. This marriage signifies unto us the mystical union which exists between Christ and the church. No human or earthly object can unite two hearts. It is the unseen hand of God that unites. Dennis, the word of God says, wife is a partner and wife of your marriage covenant. It is the covenant that you make with Sini that binds you. As you have heard and from Ephesians, let me just read very quickly. 5 verse 25 and 26 says, husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it, that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word. So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself. For no man ever yet hated his own flesh, but nourisheth and cherisheth it, even as the Lord the church. In 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 7, he says, likewise, husbands, live with your wives in an understanding way, showing honor to the woman as the weaker vessel, since they are heirs with you of the grace of life, so that your prayers may not be hindered. Sini, the Bible tells us also in 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 1 through 7, likewise, wives, be subject to your own husbands, so that even if some do not obey the word, they may be won without a word by the conduct of their wives. When they see your respectful and pure conduct, do not let your adorning be external, the braiding of hair and the putting on of gold jewelry or the clothing you wear, but let your adorning be the hidden person of the heart with the imperishable beauty of a gentle and quiet spirit, which in God's sight is very precious. For this is how the holy women who hoped in God used to adorn themselves, by submitting to their own husbands, as Sarah obeyed Abraham, calling him Lord. And you are her children if you do good and do fear anything that is frightening. In Ephesians chapter 5, Paul says, wives, submit to your own husbands as to the Lord, for the husband is the head of the wife, as also Christ is the head of the church, as he is the savior of the body. Dennis and Sini, I urge you to obey God's word and fulfill the vows you will be making to each other today. If you do obey the word of God, then you will enjoy the blessings of God. Happiness and peace will abound in your life. Let me just give you a few practical advice. I know you have both taken a premarital counseling with your pastor, but yet I just want to give you a couple of practical advices. Number one, see, for everything, as I shared with you, there is a spiritual aspect to our lives and there's a human aspect to our lives. So that we need to make sure that we both do both of it, spiritual and human aspect. When it comes to our human aspect of our lives, there are certain things that you must do very quickly. Let me just say, number one, give time and attention to each other. Family cannot be fit into any small crack of an overloaded schedule. Number two, I'm going very quickly, but number two, do not control each other. Dennis, your authority over Sini is not to please yourself, but it is only to serve the interests of Sini. Headship does not mean a husband simply makes all the decisions. Sini, it's not about getting your way in every disagreement. Work together. Third thing I want to tell you is that don't try to change the other person. Both of you are not perfect. Sorry to say that. Dennis, Sini comes as is. Sini, Dennis comes as is. That means both of you need maintenance. Right? So don't expect perfection from each other. Help each other out. Empower each other out. Make each other grow in the Lord. The last thing I want to tell you is this. Please, 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 no matter what happens, don't tell your business to other people. All right? If anybody asks you, Sini, how is Dennis? He's wonderful. He's great. Right? Dennis, somebody ask you about Sini. She's great. She's perfect. Don't tell about each other to others. That will never help you keep things between you. Don't call your mom or dad or sister or brother or best friend to complain about your spouse. Every day, make sure both of you reconcile and you go to bed in reconciliation. Never, never give a foothold to the enemy in your family life. Life may not always be smooth, but let Jesus be the captain of your ship. He only can calm the wind so that you can enjoy the ride. Let him be the master of your house, because a house built on the rock will stand against every storm. Pray together, embrace the Holy Spirit, read God's manual as we heard this morning, the Word of God, and apply it in your daily life. Let your home be filled with the sweet aroma of worship and the fragrance of God's glory. Be a vessel of healing to each other. As you grow in your relationship with each other, spiritual growth will take place also. This is a shadow of the great marriage that is about to take place very soon. Jesus, the Lamb of God, has purchased a bride with his blood shed on the cross of Calvary. Though he died for all mankind, he's not coming to receive all, but only those who call upon Jesus and who live a holy life according to the Word of God. Sini, you look so beautiful this morning. I want you all to take a look at Sini. Similarly, the heavenly groom Jesus is coming to receive a beautiful bride, holy without any spot, wrinkle, or blemish. Those of you who are hearing my voice today, if you're not prepared for the heavenly groom, I encourage you to speak to any one of the pastors after the ceremony. They will give you advice. Jesus is coming very soon. Dennis Matthew, son of Mr. and Mrs. Emma Matthew, residing at 9316 Southwest 23rd Street, Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. And Sini George, daughter of Pastor Mrs. Matthew George, residing at 38 Tamar Drive, Valley Cottage, New York, are here before God and this company of witnesses to be united in marriage. The engagement took place on Saturday, May 16th, at the Gobram Restaurant at Southwest 23rd Street, Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. It was informed in their respective churches and families, according to their decision, I'm going to conduct their marriage today. Dennis and Sini, would you stand? I'm going to ask the singers to come also. In the name of Almighty God, I ask, should there be anyone who has just cause why this couple should not be united in marriage, they should speak now or forever, hold their peace. I receive your silence as consent to proceed with the service. At this time, I ask, who gives this woman to be married to this man? Thank you. Thank you, Babungo. Shandamayanti. At this time, I'm going to ask Pastor Joseph Samuel Rajungal will come forward, and he will pray for the blessing of the service.
Let's close our eyes. Father, once again, we thank you for your presence in this place, O God. As your servant is going to solemnize this wedding, we know, Lord, your unseen hand is already in this place, that thy blessing shall be upon them, and you will enable and encourage and bless your servant to conduct this wedding, O God. Thank you for your presence. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Dennis and Sini, would you come? Look at me. Dennis, as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I require and charge you here in the holy presence of our God and the Lord Jesus Christ, as you will answer at the day of judgment when the secrets of all hearts shall be revealed, that if you know any reason, private or public, why you may not be lawfully joined together in holy matrimony, and to receive this woman who is standing at your right hand as your wife, you do now confess it. For be ye well assured that if any person joined together otherwise than as God's word doth allow, their marriage is not lawful. Is there anything? There's nothing. Good. Sini. As a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I require and charge you here in the holy presence of our God and the Lord Jesus Christ, as you will answer at the day of judgment, when the secrets of all hearts shall be revealed, that if you know any reason, private or public, why you may not be lawfully joined together in holy matrimony,
and to receive this man who is standing next to you, beside you, as your husband, you do now confess it. For be ye well assured that if any person join together otherwise than as God's word doth allow, their marriage is not lawful. Is there anything? Nothing. Dennis, in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, let me ask you, Dennis Matthew, will you have this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? I will. Will you be joined to her as long as God gives life to both of you and rely on God's grace? Will you do the duties of a husband according to the precepts of the word of God, loving, respecting, nourishing, and cherishing her? In the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, let me ask you, Sini George, will you have this man to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you be joined together to this young man only as long as God gives life to both of you and relying on God's grace in accordance with the precepts of the word? Will you do the duties of a faithful wife, loving, caring, and respecting him in submissive obedience to him? Praise the Lord. I'm going to ask you to say the vows to each other. I want you to turn around and look at each other. On this solemn occasion, as Dennis and Sini are about to exchange their marriage vows, may I ask all the ministers, would you please stand? And I would ask all the audience, as you're sitting, please keep us in your prayer as they're about to say this wedding vows. Inni mangellam shobikkuva karuna cheyga endum kanni ulla meen na cheyga endum kanni ulla ninnadi kanavil vaani vandal kongarichu ninnadi kanavil maani പണ്ടലങ്കരിച്ചു അന്നൂരസവിഞ്ഞുണ്ടാക്കി എന്ന പോലെ നേരം വന്നു അന്നൂരസവിഞ്ഞുണ്ടാക്കി എന്ന പോലെ നേരം വന്നു ഇനി മംഗല്യം ശോഭിക്കുക കരുണ ചെയ്യുക എന്നും കരിവുള്ള
May the unseen hand of the Almighty God, who united Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden, join you together in holy matrimony.
Dennis, please repeat after me, looking at Sini. I, Dennis Matthew, take you, Sini George, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, in joy and in sorrow, and in any circumstances that the Lord allows in our life, to live, to honor, to comfort, and to cherish till death do us part. And with all my earthly goods, I will do thee endow according to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I pledge thee my troth. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Sini, please repeat after me, looking into Dennis's eyes. I, Sini George, take thee, Dennis Matthew, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, in joy and in sorrow, and in any circumstances that the Lord allows in our life, to live, to honor, to comfort, and to cherish till death do us part. And with all my earthly goods, I will do thee endow according to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I pledge thee my troth. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Sorpuramee
കരാറിനു സാക്ഷി നിൽക്കും നന്മനമേ സ്വർഗസ്ഥനി നദികൾ ആശീർവാദം
Heavenly Father, I submit Dennis and Sini into your hands. May your grace be upon their lives from today onwards to obey and fulfill the vows they have made before you this morning, Lord. May their lives be full of the blessing of God. May happiness and peace abound in their lives. No weapon formed against them shall prosper. Together they shall chase 10,000 to flight. May they be a blessing to many. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. In Matthew chapter 19, verse 3 through 6, and Pharisees came to him and tested him by asking, is it lawful to divorce one's wife for any cause? He answered, have you not read that he who created them from the beginning made them male and female and said, therefore a man shall leave his father and his mother and hold fast to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. What therefore God has joined together, let no man separate. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What God has joined together, let no man separate. For as much as Dennis and Sini have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and this company, and thereto have given and pledged their troth each to the other, and have declared the same by joining hands, I pronounce by the authority vested in me as a minister of the gospel and in accordance with the laws of the state of New Jersey that they are husband and wife from this day forward. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. They are no longer two, they are one body. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no man separate. Amen. Hallelujah. I would ask all the audience, would you please, as we're going to sing a chorus of a song, I want all of you to raise your hands as a blessing and as an honor and praise to God. I'll ask them to sing. Pastor Shibu Thomas will come forward and read a psalm of blessing.
I'm reading from the company of Psalm 128 for the blessing of the newly wedded couple, Dennis and Sini, and also for the encouragement of the entire congregation. Blessed is everyone who fears the Lord, who walks in his ways. When you eat the labor of your hands, you shall be happy and it shall be well with you. Your wife shall be like a fruitful vine in the very heart of your house. Your children like olive plants all around your table. Behold, thus shall the man be blessed who fears the Lord. The Lord bless you out of Zion, and may you see the good of Jerusalem all the days of your life. Yes, may you see your children's children. Peace be upon Israel. May God richly bless by the reading of this word. I take one moment. Pastor Emma Matthew and family is the part of our church, IPC Hebron, Oklahoma. A blessed family. He's an associate pastor, serving the Lord as a family with the simplicity and sincerity of the heart. We're really proud to have them with us. And their daughter Nisi, a wonderful child of God, be the part of our worship team. Her husband is in India. Dennis, an young man, committed for the glory of the Lord, as Pastor Suju said, his heart for the kingdom of God is highly commendable. And really, I believe that the marriage between these two people is going to present a model family to the many people, and people will see the glory of the Lord moving in their life. It's my prayer that may God richly bless them on behalf of me and my wife, Reshma, and all the members of the Hebron IPC family back in Oklahoma. We really appreciate them and congratulate them. God bless them abundantly.
At this moment, Pastor Brian will come and he will pray a blessing over the couple, and I invite him to come.
Thank you. Thank you. You all look wonderful. It's a special day. I want you to take a moment and look out at your friends and family and just soak this in for a moment and just see and be warmed by the fact that they are here to not only just attend and watch, but to bless and to support you, to celebrate this day with you. And I'd like to invite your parents to come and join us as we pray for you, as we speak blessing over you. And I would also, come on up. And I would also like to ask and invite the ministers to come and as well as we circle around you and pray and ask God's blessing over you. Thank you, Lord. Father, we are so honored to be in your presence today. We are so honored that you meet us, Lord, in intimacy through Christ. Father, we thank you for this journey that is beginning today, Lord, a journey that is not just the attraction of a man to a woman and a woman to a man, but, Lord, your fingerprints, Lord, are all over this union. Let your plans coming together, Lord, that you would be glorified, that Dennis and Sini would love one another, enjoy this union and this marriage, and see you reflected in the love that they have for one another and your love for them. Father, we thank you for the legacy of their families. Father, we thank you for their mother and their father who have given so much through the years, who have sacrificed for them and served them and raised them to be a man and a woman of honor whose hearts are towards you. So we bless their families. Thank you, Lord, for the legacy that you have given them. And Lord, we pray that as they become one in this journey, that their marriage would reflect the goodness, the glory, the mystery of Christ's love for his bride, that their story would be made more complete in light of the larger story of your redemption, where Christ, in perfect obedience, went to the cross and lived the perfect life that we could not live, and died the death that we deserved so that we might be forever reconciled to God. And Father, on this journey that is full of joy, on this journey that is full of adventure, excitement, we know also that there are times where there'll be darkness and shadow and suffering. And we ask that you would embolden them, Lord, empower them to walk closely held by you, closely holding on to one another. Lord, give Dennis the empowerment of the Holy Spirit to love his wife well, to lay down his life for her and love her as Christ gave himself up for the church. And Lord, bless Sini and an abundant grace to walk alongside Dennis as the woman that you've called to be by his side. Lord, as family and friends, we see your hand upon them, and we stand back in amazement, and we praise and glorify you, Lord. Thank you for this union, that their lives continually grow deeper and deeper in you, that they might live and breathe and have their being in you. And we pray these things in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Dennis and Sini, the The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. And the Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen.
Praise God. At this time, I request Suja Kodumthara to come forward to sing a song. That will be the opportunity of signing of documents. And those who are responsible, including, you know, they are there, maybe the father of both the parents, and also the witnesses will come forward to sign the documents. Suja Kodumthara.
There must be a God, I believe it's true. I can see his love when I look at you. And he must have a plan for this crazy life. 'Cause he brought you here and placed you by my side. And I have never been so sure of anything before, like I am in this moment here with you. Now for better or for worse, so much more than only words. And I pray every day will be the proof that I mean what I say when I say I do. Yes, I mean what I say when I say I do. You see, these hands you hold will always hold you up when the strength you have just ain't strong enough. And what tomorrow brings, only time will tell. But I'll stand by you in sickness and in health. 'Cause I have never been so sure of anything before, like I am in this moment here with you. And now for better or for worse, so much more than only words. And I pray every day will be the proof that I mean what I say when I say I do. Yeah, I mean what I say when I say. Take my hand and take this ring and know that I will always love you through anything. Yeah, and as the years march on, like a beating heart, I will live these words till death do us part. 'Cause I have never been so sure of anything before, like I am in this moment here with you. And now for better or for worse, so much more than only words. And I pray every day will be the proof that I mean what I say when I say I do. Yeah, I mean what I say when I say I do.
Amen. Thank you, Sister Suja. We are so blessed and privileged to have Pastor Joseph Daniel with us on this blessed occasion. He will come forward for closing prayer and benediction.
I congratulate both of you. I have known both of you, families and you, for the last many years. Both of you have good spiritual heritage and legacy. Keep it up. Glorify God in everything you do. One last thing, God is the one who instituted the marriage. He can resolve all the issues when you face. Praise the Lord. Let's pray. Kartave, njangal orumichu prarthikunnu. ഈ കുടുംബത്തിന് വേണ്ടി ഞങ്ങൾ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. ദൈവത്തിൻ്റെ കരം അവർക്ക് വേണ്ടി അവർ ഇറങ്ങി പ്രവർത്തിക്കണമേ. ഇന്നത്തെ അവരുടെ സന്തോഷവും സമാധാനവും മരണം വരെ നിൽപ്പാനിടയാക്കണമേ. അങ്ങയുടെ കാഹളം ധ്വനിക്കുന്നിടം വരെ അവരുണ്ടായിരിക്കാനിടയാക്കണമേ. ഞങ്ങൾ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവേ. ഈ കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങളെ അനുഗ്രഹിക്കണമേ. സ്പിരിച്വലി, ഫിസിക്കലി, മെൻ്റലി, ഫിനാൻഷ്യലി എല്ലാ നിലയിലും ദൈവം ഇവരെ അനുഗ്രഹിപ്പാൻ ഞങ്ങൾ ഒരുമിച്ച് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവേ. ഈ വിവാഹ ശുശ്രൂഷ നടത്താൻ കർത്താവിൻ്റെ ദാസൻ പാസ്റ്റർ ജോൺസിനെ ദൈവം സഹായിച്ചതിനായി സ്തോത്രം. രണ്ട് പ്രിയപ്പെട്ടവരുടെയും കൂട്ടത്തിൽ കടന്നു വന്ന മാതാപിതാക്കൾ, സഹോദരങ്ങൾ, സ്നേഹിതർ, പാസ്റ്റേഴ്സ് എല്ലാവരെയും ഞങ്ങൾ ഓർത്ത് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. എല്ലാവരും നീ അനുഗ്രഹിക്കണമേ. ഈ വിവാഹത്തിന് വേണ്ടി എല്ലാവർക്കും പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കാൻ ദൈവം ഇനിയും കൃപ കൊടുക്കണമേ. തുടർന്നുള്ള എല്ലാ കാര്യങ്ങളിലും കർത്താവിൻ്റെ സാന്നിധ്യം ഉണ്ടാകുവാനിടയാക്കണമേ. ഇവർ ഇരുവരുടെയും ബന്ധങ്ങൾ അന്യോന്യമുള്ള കുടുംബങ്ങളിലും ദൈവസഭകൾക്കും ദേശത്തിനും രാജ്യത്തിനും അതൊരു ബ്ലെസ്സിങ്ങായി തീരുവാനിടയാക്കണമേ. ഞങ്ങൾ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. സ്വർഗത്തിലെ ദൈവമേ, സകല ആത്മീയ ഭൗതിക നന്മകളാൽ നീ കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങളെ അനുഗ്രഹിപ്പാൻ ഞങ്ങൾ ആത്മാർത്ഥമായി പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. ആ തുടർന്നുള്ള എല്ലാ കാര്യങ്ങളിലും കർത്താവിൻ്റെ കരുണ കാണിക്കണമേ. പ്രാർത്ഥന കേട്ടതിനായി സ്തോത്രം. യേശുവിൻ തന്നെ പിതാവായ ദൈവത്തിൻ്റെ സ്നേഹവും പുത്രനായ ക്രിസ്തുവിൻ്റെ കൃപയും വിട്ടുപിരിയാത്ത പരിശുദ്ധാത്മാവിൻ്റെ വലിയ സഹിത്വവും ഫ്രണ്ട്ഷിപ്പും ഇന്ന് വിവാഹിതരായ പ്രിയ കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങളോടും ഇവിടെ കടന്നു വന്ന എല്ലാ ദൈവമക്കളോടും ദൈവദാസന്മാരോടും കർത്താവിൻ്റെ വരുവരെയും ഉണ്ടാവുമാറാകട്ടെ. ആമേൻ.
ലേഡീസ് ആൻഡ് ജെന്റിൽമെൻ, ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് മൈ ജോയ് ആൻഡ് പ്രിവിലേജ് നൗ ടു ഇൻട്രൊഡ്യൂസ് ടു യു ദ ന്യൂലി വെഡഡ് കപ്പിൾ, മിസ്റ്റർ ആൻഡ് മിസ്സസ് ഡെന്നിസ് മാത്യു.